All right, so I generated the maze. I decided I was going to put the player in there and see how it felt running around inside the maze. So that's what I have so far. I still feel like, oh no, I still feel like I have a lot to go. The maze is generating while I'm playing, which I don't want. Because you can see a pretty clear path of which way to go, and then you could also collide with that ball. Either. And sometimes the stinking thing goes to the wall. It has to do with it hitting me. See right now how it's hitting me? It has to do with that. But since it's generating as I'm playing, I have no way to tell if that's the reason. So to fix it, I'm gonna have to make a menu scene and generate the level during the menu scene. And then, so far there hasn't been any place I couldn't reach with wall jumping. It can get hard though sometimes, which is cool. Yeah, so that's where I'm at so far. I can control the zoom of the camera. I don't have it turned on right now, but I guess I could, that's something I can add to the code. Press a key or something, then the camera zooms in and out. I'm gonna make that part of the difficulty of the game. Okay, and then the exit, the entrance is gonna always sort of be up in the corner. Or I might do random entrance, random exit too, I don't know. But I have like an exit like this. So during the menu screen, I'm going to be generating one maze to play. I think it's all going to be one gigantic level, like with the menu screen up here in the corner. Then a maze down here is generating while the menu is running. And then the play button appears once the first maze is done generating. The second bigger maze is generating somewhere else on the screen. And then once you complete this maze by hitting the exit, you'll teleport over to the bigger maze, and then a even bigger maze will be generated in the first position. So I keep doing that where you're swapping between two mazes while the next one's generating. And hopefully it'll take you long enough to solve the maze that you don't get teleported into the maze as it's being generated. If all that makes any sense at all. Yeah, so that's where I'm at right now. I think I'm gonna work on that level of like generating the small maze and then being able to play that, hit play and play that small maze while the other bigger maze is generating. So. That's what's the cool thing about everything being a scene. This maze, I can instantiate mazes, basically instantiate levels that generate themselves in my game scene. And that's what I'm gonna do next. So, just to show it one more time, just to test it out one more time for myself. Levels generating. And see, I wanna have like pickups. Certain pickups. Maybe you have to find three coins or three code pieces since he's Code Chomper. Oh, but see, like stuff like that can't go on. Can't do that. The level has to be completely generated before I let the player start playing. Before the player even spawns in. Which is, I think, a fairly easy task to do. I say think because it could be hard. But there I am. So, like, imagine if there's something in this top right corner, I'd have to go, or in that bottom corner right there, to find my way up there. And you can see it's not a perfect maze. It does have some of these standalone platforms. Then again, I'm running out of time. So I need to work on the gameplay, the maze generation. If I want to make it perfect, I'll have to wait. Anyways, made it to the bottom corner. Yay for Code Chomper. Okay. Stop playing my own game and start building main game. I'm gonna make a new scene. We'll start off with a node. They don't have any parameters. They're the lightest weight thing. This is gonna be my game. So game, boom. You notice node doesn't even have a position or anything. So have the game. What are we gonna put in the game? We're gonna need. We're going to need a menu system. And so, I'll make another scene. I'll make sure my game saved here. It doesn't look like it did. So I'll make sure I keep these things organized. See, the PUP code's not even in the right space. Okay. Just to make sure that everything's working, let's run it one more time. Looks like it's working good. 1 second, please. I'll be right back. I'll make a phone call. All right, so I keep finding it's driving me nuts. I keep finding instances where the maze doesn't complete correctly. It's gonna break my gameplay, I think. Especially if it like leaves the maze completely and exits in a spot you can't get to. Gosh, kind of sucks. I don't know what to do. Adjust the camera zoom real quick. 0.5, 0.5. That way, hopefully, oops. Didn't look like that did anything. Oh. Okay, so smaller number brings it in closer. We'll say 3, 3. There we go. Looks funny when you play it this far away. Looks slow. But yeah, so I'll be able to adjust the camera zoom to change the difficulty of the level. So I have the game itself. We're gonna make a menu. We're gonna save this scene. We're gonna call we need a root node first. We'll call this menu. And we're gonna save it. Save it in our scenes folder. Keep everything organized. We're gonna do some UI stuff now. I don't know how to do UI in Godot. The button. Oh, it looks pretty simple. That's awesome compared to other. Play. Oh yeah. Looks super easy. I don't know if you've done UI in other systems, but man, this one's easy. New. Let's see if there's a way to like make it larger. Change the font size at least. Okay, dang it. It's not that easy. So, instead of that, maybe I'll just make an image that you can click. I think that's what I'm going to do. So, I'm going to use my trusty iPad. Sorry, I shouldn't have looked at my email. Alright, I'm gonna make a button. Do I have a custom? Yes, I have a custom option. 64, 32. Cool, perfect. If you didn't see earlier, I use a app called Pixakai, and I draw on my iPad, and then I push it over to my computer. So, like this, fill it in, and draw the word play. Which is harder to than say. I'm actually going to erase a whole entire pixel border for this so I can make an onclick handler for the image. Here in a minute, I will be going to eat. Gotta eat. But I'll stream later too, so keep tuned. I'll be doing this all weekend. Okay, so I got a basic play button. Very silly looking. Gonna make another instance of it, select it all, and then just move it down and to the right a little bit. And then that's just gonna give it the illusion of being like depressed. And when you click it. Alright, so I will call that good for now. Name it something that makes sense. Button. I will name it play button. Done. Play button is the oops. Now I share it to my Dropbox is how I'm handling this. Been working great all day today, so knock on wood. So, I have Dropbox open already. Oh, I thought I did. I have a key for that. Inside my art folder, I'm going to make a new folder called Play Button. Open up that folder. Go into the art. You can see a zip of play button. We'll just extract it all in place. And we'll grab these two things. Drag it over here. They look almost exactly the same, but they are not. There's a 1 pixel down and to the right shift. So our scene, we're actually going to put in a animated sprite. This is going to be called button. Oh. Play button. Frames, it says none. We'll say new. Animation. How did I do this? Edits. This is default. Default will be frame one. A new animation. This will be hover. That'll be frame two. Luckily, I believe that this node type has a signal. Oh, guess not. So, there's gonna be a better way to do this. So let's look at button again. Texture button. Perfect. There we go. Normal, and then we're going to actually load the textures. That's the way to do it. So normal is going to be frame one. Press will be frame two. Hover will be frame two. Disabled, I don't have one. It'll just be normal. Focused will be one. And we'll leave that the same. We'll delete this. And we'll take our button around. Let's actually look at this and see how this works. You want to hover over it? Boom! Boom! Clicking made it really funny. Wonder why that happened. I mean, that might have been the focus thing. That's what it was. It was focused. All right. So we have a silly button. That took way too long. It took a lot longer than it should have. I am going to see what size is our project. Project settings. Our project settings. I'm trying to figure out how big my scene is. Window. 1024 by 600. I'm going to sketch a few things. This time. Yeah, this time I'm going to use an application called Procreate on my iPad. And then I'm going to make a new canvas of that size. Oops. Totally messed up there. I'm gonna use Procreate. I'm gonna make a screen that has like the little code chomper guy and whatnot. And like information how to play and stuff. Bear with me while I do this. It's 1024 by an odd size, but that's okay. So first layer, I want it to have a background color. So Procreate, you can change the background color. We are gonna do like a darker color. I'm gonna turn up my brightness. What the heck I'm doing. Okay, so my pen, streamline. I haven't come up with a name for this yet. I haven't come up with a name for it yet. That's so unlike me. I've worked on it this whole time. Let's see. Maybe I'll call it Amazing Escape. I'm going to hand draw this text. Give it a little bit more flair. Don't like my G. Don't like that G. Oh my gosh. Don't like that either. I can't draw a G right now. Amazing Escape. Escape. All right, Amazing Escape. I'm gonna add a new layer. I want to draw my code chomper guy. He's always fun to draw. Got these big circle eyes. This is coming out pretty funny. So you're here in a second. Fill, I need to use the fill. Oh yeah, I forgot about how this works. It works with a drag to fill method. It's super cool. I wish more applications did this way. You just drag the color from the corner. I can't really show it, but you drag the color from the corner and you let go, and it fills. But apparently that shape wasn't closed. And it's not. One on this color, I give him his little teeth. this may not say my logo, but for now, we're doing Amazing Escape like that. It's pretty much a placeholder. Select one, share it, PNG. Did I not pick Dropbox? What's going on here? Cancel. Share. PNG. Dropbox. Give it to Art. Choose. Weird. I had to put an email address to share it to, so I used my own. There it is. Showed up right there. Didn't name it. So I'll name it here. Intro screen. So cool. Sorry about that. It took a little while. So we'll close this. The menu here will have an intro screen now. Once I import it. Boom. We're going to put the intro above the button. We're also going to set this to transform 0, 0. Shoot. Now, looking at it, the play button looks a little small. We'll scale it up. Oh, didn't work. Yeah, I'll scale these bad boys too. Import them. Huh. Button. Let's see if there's a scale somewhere. There we go. So let's run this scene. I know it looks kind of silly, but Amazing Escape. And then I have pixel art mixed with smooth art. I may fix that. Okay, well, right now, clicking on the button does absolutely nothing, but we will fix that shortly. What we do want to do is bring in a maze. And to do that, we'll go over here to our scenes, and I have the maze node here. Drag it over. Probably oh wow, so since the root node of maze is not node 2D, I can't move it. We need to change that. So it's pretty easy. We change the type. We'll say node the change. That way, this thing has a transform now that we can move. So we actually want to be able to move the maze. Makes sense, right? Be able to move the maze. Heck. We may actually put some code in here. And we're going to get rid of the player. We're going to put some code in our script, in our maze script, for our offset. We're actually going to export it so we can change it. So export our offset backdoor. Okay, we'll go back to our 2D scene. We have our maze and say, what's our offset? We'll set it to 0, and we'll just actually move it straight below our menu. And set this to 2000. Okay, go to the script, and inside here, just posted a link to the game so far. It doesn't have any of the cool maze stuff yet, but that's coming soon. If you want to play it, go for it. Now that I have offset, I'm going to say position. Very transform. So the game's there. On the menu, I'm going to get rid of the maze because the maze doesn't go on the menu. The maze will go on the game. We need to put the menu on our game. Okay, let's add a maze. Maze, and we could say 1,000. Let's hit play and see what happens. I am not sure what's going to happen. Hoping that offset worked. And I think it did. Zoom out. I don't see a maze anywhere. I think it's way down there. Let's just set it to 1,030. Okay, we'll run this scene. Expand it. Don't see the maze. Make sure the maze works. What the heck? The offset's working. Don't know why. Seemed like it wasn't. Oops. Maze is part of that. Okay. We're getting there. 700. Forgot that the window was only 600 tall. I was thinking it was 1,000 tall. So 700. We play this. You won't see the you won't see the maze, but the maze is actually being generated down below. Okay, so now we need to put on the menu. The menu itself. Shoot. Button pressed. The game's gonna have a script. It's going to be game script. Sure, why not? Go back to the 2D view, game, go to the texture button, on pressed, we're gonna connect that to the game. Connect. Now we have on texture press. Cool. Alright, so once we hit play, we're going to have to do few things. We're going to have to create a player. We're going to have to stick the player in the very first section of the maze. I think the maze will have to signal us when it's done and we'll enable the button or not. But for now, we'll just instantiate the player and move the camera down there. I think the player has a camera. So we'll say export packed scene. Player obj, player scene. Like that better, okay? And then I can say player bar player. Good days. We are also going to bring in a maze. We're gonna generate the maze on run. So export packed scene. Our maze scene. We're actually going to start that on get go. Save our maze. This is maze A. We're going to have two mazes. We're going to say maze A equals a scene dot instance maze a dot offset equals vector 2 0 on the x and 700 vertical. Okay, so we'll actually go in here, we're going to drop our, we're not going to have a maze node, it'll be generated at runtime. Same with our player. So you see here we have our maze scene and our player scene, so we need to bring those there. Here's our player. Okay. Player position equals maze a dot offset. Let's run this, see what happens. It's probably going to break. We didn't add these actually, so we created them, we didn't add them yet. So add child maze A, add child player, add child. Worked pretty good. I missed where I was at. My player camera's way zoomed out. we'll say 1 and 1 again, because I kind of liked that zoom level. Game. I'm going to see how to throw a signal. I don't know how to do that, but I know Godot can do it. It's one of his strong suits. Godot, send signal. Go. Emit signal, my signal. Okay, so when Maze finishes, which happens, will actually happen on the outside of this while loop. You just say send signal. No, emit. Emit signal. Maze done. Maze built. Built. Okay. Save that. Our game. We're gonna register for that signal, I believe. Connect my signal to self. Similar. Simple. Here's the game script. Okay, and on ready. Gonna do this. Connect. Maze. Built. Myself. And the function maze. Built. Function here. Actually, we'll follow the convention of doing on maze built. So, func on maze built. We're just going to print maze is built just to make sure I'm getting the signal. Save it. We'll run the game itself. We'll wait for that maze to be built. It will take a while. Debugger. I think I need to do that there. That. Okay, that didn't work. Weird. Oh, I gotta make a signal. Okay, I see. Back to non-existence, no maze built, new method. I think we're working, Not quite built yet. The maze finishes, we should see boom. What's that here? We didn't see it. Darn, I'm not catching the signal. It's not put right there. Oh, sleepy. And the ball comes back, whatever it does. French. Tore off through the maze. I will just export it. Inside. You get this button and change its visibility. do I do that? Okay, I'm ready. We're gonna hide it. So, menu. So, boom. Run this thing. Why is the button hiding? Or isn't hiding? Looks like the maze built. Fires right away. That's not working. I'll show the button before it's built. Amazing escape. When's my button gonna show up? Oh my gosh, the maze is just tearing up right now. Hasn't worked a single time. We're gonna finish. I'm just getting a rash of bad mazes. Like, okay, well, gotta fix my maze. Have to fix it. Didn't do anything. Alright. Why it keeps messing up. Maze, I have a else in the script to allow me to generate mazes without closing it and opening it. Alright, so I found a way I can test my maze algorithm easier. I'm gonna stop streaming here. Go have some lunch, early dinner. And when I return, I'm going to continue working on my maze algorithm so I don't end up having broken mazes, broken levels. Because that would kill the whole entire game. Alright, feeling discouraged, but maybe some pizza will help. Alright, later.